Welcome to Engineering Python. This is a Python programming course for engineers. In this video, I will talk about how to implement loops using the while statement. This is the syntax of the while loop. The keyword while, followed by a boolean condition, ended with a colon. The statement block is indented. The while loop repeatedly executes the statement block as long as the condition is true. It stops when the condition is false. The while loop is an indefinite loop. The number of iterations is not known until the loop has been terminated. Let's see some examples. I already talked about the for loop in the previous video in this course. This for loop will print 5 integer numbers from 0 to 5, including 0 but not including 5. It is equivalent to the following while loop. Initialize I to be 0. While I is less than 5, we print I and update I by adding 1 to itself. So I's value will be 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. After we print out 4, I's value will be increased by 1, so it's 5. 5 is not less than 5. So this condition is false. The loop stops. To summarize, the while loop requires us to manage the loop variable I by initializing it to 0 before the loop and increasing it at the bottom of the body. In the for loop, this is handled automatically. A common mistake while using the while loop is forgetting to accumulate the loop index I. The following program will lead to an endless or infinite loop. We initialize I to be 0. We check if the condition is less than 5. It always is, because we forget to increase I's value by 1, and so I is always 0. The program will print 0 repeatedly, and this loop will never end. To force the code to terminate, you can try the following. Click the Jupyter Notebook menu, Kernel, Restart. If it doesn't work, press Ctrl-C multiple times in the terminal that is associated with this Jupyter Notebook to interrupt the connected Jupyter Notebook server. If the browser like Chrome, Firefox, and Internet Explorer is unresponsive, try to bring out the Task Manager using Ctrl-Alt-DL to kill the browser program. If your computer freezes, as a last resort, unplug the power and remove the battery. You can use a while loop to interact with the user. For example, we may ask if the user needs to input more data during each iteration of the loop. In this program, we initialize k to be 0. K represents how many numbers we want to calculate the average for. The total is also initialized to be 0. It represents the sum of these numbers. More is a mark we use to indicate whether the user wants to input more data. Its initial value is yes. This while loop will check the first character of this more variable. The index is 0. If it is a lowercase letter y or an uppercase letter y, then we ask the user to give us the number, update k and the total, and at last ask if they want to enter more numbers. If the user doesn't want to enter more numbers, they should answer no or any word that doesn't start with a lowercase or uppercase letter y. Finally, we calculate the average and print out the results. Run this program, enter a number, I give it a 4, more numbers, I type in y, which means yes, enter another number, 5, yes for more numbers. Enter a number, negative 3. For this question, my answer is yeah. Enter a number, 2. I don't have more numbers, so nope. The while loop ends. Here is the result. I entered 4 numbers. The total is 8. The average is 2. The interactive mode is great, but it is tedious to answer the question every time before we enter a number. It turns out we don't have to go through this pain. We can simplify the program by using a sentinel loop. The sentinel is the condition that signals the end of the loop. It must be different from the data themselves. In the following example, we calculate the average of testing scores entered by the user. If an input is greater than 100 or less than 0, the loop stops because they are out of the range. In this main function, we initialize k and the total. We ask the user to enter the first number. That means the first item is retrieved before the loop starts. If the first item is a sentinel, that means if the number is out of the range, the loop terminates and no data is processed. Otherwise, the item is processed and the next one is read. Run this program, enter a number between 0 and 100, others to quit. I enter 85, another number 95, and then 75. I don't have any more, so negative 1, which is less than 0. The while loop stops. Output the results. You entered 3 numbers between 0 and 100. The total is 255. The average is 85. What if the numbers we input can take both positive and negative values? For example, outdoor temperatures can be positive or negative. In this case, we may use a special character such as Q, which means quit, E, which means exit, or even an empty string by just hit the enter key to signal the end of the loop. In the program, we ask the user to enter a number, and if they directly hit enter, the loop will stop. Otherwise, we will process the number. Run this program. Enter a number. Hit enter to quit. I type in negative 80, which is a valid negative number. Then another number, 4, and another, 90. I don't have any more numbers, so I hit enter directly. The program prints you entered 3 numbers. The total is 14. The average is about 4.7. Okay, that was all about the while loop. The course materials are available on YouTube and GitHub. You can watch the course videos in sequence. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. I'm Yong Wang. Thanks for watching.